Hello, High Levelers, Rayo Daniel here, and in this video, what I want to do is help you fix or correct a problem that you may not know you have inside the GoHighlevel platform. If you're currently an agency and you're servicing clients and you have sub-accounts with clients in them, you may have a problem that you're not aware of. So right now, what I want to go over are what are branded domains. This is something that has been introduced to the GoHighlevel platform that I have not seen a lot of people take advantage of. And it's something that could be a little bit confusing when it comes to your clients and developing automations and basically how the links that your clients submit out to people look like. Now, let me explain this because it is a little bit complicated. So I'm going to hop in and let's take a look at this. Okay, so right now I'm actually at the agency level. And what I want to do is I want to come over here to the agency level and I want to go to the company level. And then what I want to do is come down here to the area where it says white label and API domain. Now, I want to speak about this for just a minute because whenever we set up the GoHighlevel platform as an affiliate, I am an affiliate for the GoHighlevel platform. So one of the things I do is I help my affiliates get their account set up so they're able to get going in their business right away. One of the main things that we actually do in this particular process is we set up their white label domain if they don't already have that set up, and we set up their API domain. Now, a lot of people don't understand what the API domain is or does. So right now, what I want to do is help explain that. Anytime you send a link out, whether it be a calendar link, a form link, a trigger link, anything like that, link itself, if you don't have an API domain, will go to high levels like MSG, MGRN, something.com domain. It's a generic domain that GoHighlevel uses. But the problem is when you send that link out from your agency or from a client to another potential customer, it can be a little bit confusing because the domain name of the link doesn't match the domain name of the business sending it. And that can be scammy and spammy, and a lot of people may not want to click on there because they might not want to be redirected someplace they're not meant to go. So what Highlevel did is Highlevel actually created an API domain. Now, when you set this up at the agency level, the API domain basically just says this, whatever you put in here, which in this case is going to be link.mydomain.smb360.io, that is my API domain. So anything that gets sent out with any subdomain, and here's the issue. Any subdomain that is under my account, whether it be a client, whether it be anybody else, when they send out a link, a calendar link, a form link, or a trigger link, and an SM, and the biggest thing is like the trigger links is where it gets confusing. It will have the agency level link API domain on it, not the domain of the current subaccount. So I hope that is clear. A lot of people don't understand and don't see that, but let me go ahead and show you what I mean. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hop into one of my demo accounts here. The name of this company is just Digi Global Agency. It's a fake marketing company that I use for my demos. But right now what I've done is I've created an automation. And right now what I've done here is I've created this automation right here called Branded Domain Workflow. And right now the whole point of it is I just wanted to send out an SMS message. There's no trigger or anything like that. I just wanted to send out an SMS message. And then the SMS message is basically saying, here is my trigger link, and then I inserted one of the trigger links that I've used in a previous example. It doesn't really matter the actual trigger link that you use. What matters is how it looks whenever it gets sent out. So right now, I'm going to go ahead and show you. So I'm going to pop back over. I had this sent to another one of my accounts. So right now, this is what this link looks like. Here's my trigger link, and it gives it a link. Notice where it is. This is not my domain. This is, if you can imagine, your client, a fake customer. The name of this business is digiglobalagency.com, not this smb360.io. They're like, what is that? You know, when your clients get that, they're like, I don't get this. Who is this company or what is this? I don't want to click on this link because I don't feel it's safe. So this is where the problem comes in, is whenever your clients want to send out a link or links in their sub account, then it needs to be set up with their domain link on it. Now, how do you do that? Easy. You just use the branded domain function. So right now what we're going to do is go back here. Well, now we're going to go, this is the Digi Global Agency. This is your client sub account. You're going to come into the settings. And then from here, you're going to scroll down and you're going to be dealing with this area right here, the branded domain. So right now, this branded domain is what we need to actually get set up as an API domain for the local business. Now, I'm going to go ahead and get this set up here. Give me just a second. All right, here. So now what we have to do is come up and decide with what we're going to be calling the name of this link. And just for my own sake, you can call have the link be whatever it is, but typically it's going to be a subdomain of your existing domain. Okay, so right now I'm just going to use the word link. That's just my term. You could use whatever you want, but I'm going to use the local client, the business domain that's configured at the client level here in order to do this. So I'm going to go ahead and get this set up. And right now, once we set this up, we've got just link, digiglobalagency.com. Click on add domain. Notice that this is here. Now, here's one of the things I want to point out. With the GoHighlevel platform, if your domain is under Google, if it's under GoDaddy or if it's under Cloudflare, or if you've actually purchased it now under the Highlevel platform, which you can actually do, that's a new feature, then the DNS records are going to be configured for you automatically. If you're not in any one of those four, you will need to come down here and actually do an add record manually and actually put this record manually into your system. Now, right now, I am one of those, so I'm just going to sit back. It's going to go through, and this is the privilege, I guess, the benefit of switching your records to a provider that can do this, is that once you log in, it's just as simple as, oh, I need to create this record for you. Great. I'm going to go ahead and click authorize, and I need to type this in here. So I'm going to go ahead and get this typed in, authorize. Now, as long as you're not using this subdomain, this link.digiglobalhq.com, there's no problems with getting your record configured. But sometimes it can be complicated to go in and get the records configured. Some providers, actually, there's a delay. It could be hours, or it could even be a whole day before that record then becomes available inside the GoHighlevel platform for you to be able to use. Where, as you see right here, that took, you know, maybe 10 seconds or something like that. But now we've got the domain set up here. Notice that it's grayed out like it was before, but now we have a branded domain inside of our account. So now when we do that, what we're going to do is I'm going to hop back over here into my contacts, and I'm going to choose my John Smith, which is the fake user I've got set up. I'm going to go ahead and put him back to that same automation. That's the one, the branded domain. Again, I'm just going to do test one. It doesn't really matter what we call the action here. And we're just going to do add to automation. And what this is going to do, all it's going to do is just run this person through the workflow. And then what it's going to do is end up sending out another text. But when we send out another text, now look at the difference. The difference now with your trigger link says link.digiglobalagency.com, not the agency level link domain. So this is the benefit of, and you might need to adjust your onboarding process whenever you onboard to go in and configure that branded domain for your client, because it will be beneficial whenever they're doing trigger links and things like this. Because if somebody understands and are familiar with DigiGlobal Agency, they would feel much better about clicking on this link right here and going to whatever trigger link that you send out or whatever than they would be for this one right here, because they don't even know who this is. Now, you as your business, you know what it is, because that would be your agency or something like that, but the client doesn't. So hopefully you understand, and now this is a simple change that you can just simply make another line item on your onboarding checkmark. But it is very important, and it's something that I see that people have been missing whenever they're looking at getting their client set up. So guys, I hope you found this useful. Real quick, hurry. My job here is to give you information that's going to help you be more successful in the GoHighlevel platform. If you did learn something, if you didn't know about this, click on the like button, click on the comment, leave me some feedback here so that I can get this video posted and get it sent out to other people. If you have not subscribed, subscribe to my channel. I have a ton of stuff on this channel that's going to make you be more beneficial to you and make you more successful in the GoHighlevel platform. Now, my final plug on this one here is, again, I am a GoHighlevel affiliate. If you have not signed up for GoHighlevel, I do have a 30-day free trial link in the description below. Please check it out. I give you a ton of bonuses, benefits, things like that. Guys, thanks for paying attention, being here with me on the video, and have a great day. Bye-bye.